Hello, my dear friends. I'm glad to welcome you back to my channel. Today, I decided to dedicate my video to the youngest sister of Suleiman and tell you about her difficult fate. Watch this video until the end and you will find out why Sultan Suleiman married his younger sister to a eunuch. And before I start my story, I ask you to support my channel. Statistics show that many viewers watch my videos without a subscription. Therefore, I beg you to subscribe to my channel. This is how you help my channel grow. And your likes and comments motivate me to create interesting videos for you. Please give this video a like and subscribe to the channel. And I wish you a pleasant viewing. In 1500, in Trabzon, being the beloved woman of Selim Yavuz, Hafsa Sultan gave birth to a girl. It was Fatma Sultan. Fatma Sultan was the last child born to Hafsa Sultan. Fatma is the youngest of all Suleiman's sisters. The girl had a cheerful character. An interesting fact is that Fatma Sultan was loved by the Janissaries. Whether it is because she supported her nephew Shehzade Mustafa, or because she was the daughter of Selim Yavuz. In the archival documents of the Topkapi Palace Museum, there were records where Fatma Sultan was described as a very smart woman, outwardly resembling her father Yavuz, and in her upbringing and behavior like her mother Hafsa Sultan. Obeying the will of her own father, Fatma Sultan married Mustafa Pasha, who at that time was the Sanjak Bey of Antalya. The family life of the Sultana with this man was long. But her husband began to cheat on her. Fatma Sultan endured this humiliation for a long time, but her patience came to an end. She complained to her father in a letter and asked to be divorced from her unfaithful husband. The Sultan allowed the divorce, and Fatma returned to the palace. Necdet Sacoglu described this version in his book. But let's think together. Fatma got married and lived with her first husband for many years. If we take into account the fact that the Sultana was born in 1500, then she could get married at about the age of 16 to 17. They write that in her first marriage she lived for many years. Selim Yavuz died in 1520. And this means that she could only write a letter asking for a divorce to her brother Suleiman, who inherited the throne after Selim Yavuz. After the divorce, Fatma Sultan returned to Topkapi. It was from that moment that we could observe her fate in the TV series, The Magnificent Century. At first, Fatma seemed harmless to harem. But soon the Sultana began to take part in intrigues against the wife of her brother, the Sultan. There are no records in the archives of Topkapi about the real relationship between Fatma Sultan and harem. But in some books you can find passages that describe the details of the relationship between these two women. And judging by them, they did not develop very well. And that's why. In a real story, Fatma Sultan and Alkaz Mirza had a secret love relationship, for which Mirza was executed. This is written in the documents, which indicate the reasons for his execution. The second time, Fatma Sultan married for love. Ahmed Kara Pasha became her chosen one. The couple truly loved each other. The gifts given by Ahmed Kara Pasha to Fatma and the deeds that Fatma did after the death of her husband testify to great love. The Sultana married Ahmed Kara Pasha in 1522. A year later, Fatma's husband became Grand Vizier. He served in this position from 1553 to 1555. Rumors reached Sultan Suleiman that his son-in-law, the Grand Vizier, was taking bribes. These rumors were spread by harem in order to return the post to her son-in-law Rustem Pasha. Ahmed Kara Pasha was executed and Rustem Pasha again became the Grand Vizier. This indicates that the relationship between Fatma and harem was bad. During the reign of Sultan Selim II, it became known that Ahmed Pasha was unjustly executed. And he wasn't to blame. Selim summoned his aunt to him and apologized to her for his father. But this only helped restore the honor of the unjustly killed Ahmed Pasha and did not give Fatma any consolation. Fatma Sultan suffered for a very long time from the loss of her husband. Perhaps if she had children, she would find at least some solace in them. But she had no children. The first husband ignored her as a woman. Therefore, she had no children from this marriage. And she simply could not have children from her second husband, whom she loved very much, due to her age. After all, when she married him, she was already 52 years old. Suleiman, when he was alive, could not look at the suffering of his younger sister. And he persuaded the eunuch Ibrahim Pasha to become her husband. Of course, this marriage was just a way to distract Fatma from loneliness. The couple lived together for only 1 year. Fatma's third husband also died. However, there was evidence that indicates that Fatma Sultan herself asked Suleiman to marry her to the eunuch Ibrahim Pasha. She was very pious and wanted to make the pilgrimage, the Hajj. And unmarried women were not allowed to perform Hajj. Fatma Sultan died of old age in 1573. For that time, she lived a fairly long life, 73 years. The Sultana was buried close to her beloved husband Ahmed Pasha, for whom she yearned until the last day of her life. Fatma Sultan was the only one of Suleiman's sisters who was married 3 times, but remained childless. Her last husbands died shortly after they married her. She, like the other sisters of Suleiman, remained a widow in her old age and met her death in anguish and loneliness. I thank you for watching. Give this video a like. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And continue to stay with me so as not to miss new interesting stories about the Ottoman Empire. See you soon.